It's St. Patty's Day. Erin go bragh, Ireland forever. And when it comes to the Irish traditions here in Hawaii, you can't get much better than this. I'm joined by Major, Pipe Major Dan Quinn.
Morning.
And Tina Yap, aloha and good morning. Now, you guys are from the, let me get this right, the Celtic pipes and drums of Hawaii, right?
That's right.
Now, I've seen you guys around, but you're kind of especially, it's a special year for you. You're celebrating a special anniversary for your group. Talk about that.
We are, yes. This is the 30th anniversary of our band. We started originally as the Shamrock Pipes and Drums.
Okay.
And then later became the Celtic Pipes and Drums of Hawaii in 1985. So this represents our 30th year.
Now, when you talk about representing the culture and the real feelings that you guys represent, we see you at parades, we see you at things around town. But I got to ask for you, what is it you like? You're the pipe major. You are almost an embodiment and representation of the culture. Is that a lot of pressure? Is it a lot of honor? Well, how does that feel for you, sir, I must ask?
Well, I'm honored. Basically, the band lets me believe I'm in charge. I get to pick the tunes. If I don't remember one, I don't select it.
Now, when you talk about the tunes, can we talk a little bit about this beautiful instrument, the bagpipe? I've always wanted to play, but talk, is it a challenging instrument? Is it interesting? I mean, it's a very unique musical device, you should say, right?
It really is. Tina, why don't you
tell us about it?
It's difficult. it's kind of like patting your head and rubbing your stomach. You blow through this. It's the blow stick. And this is the chanter where the melody comes out. And then these are the drones where that humming sound that you hear.
That unique sound.
Correct. You blow the bag up, you strike it, and it forces the air out through the drones, and then you blow a little harder, and the melody comes out.
I gotta ask, I mean, it's a unique way you were saying blowing, pushing at the same time, but, I mean, is it difficult to learn? How long does it take if someone wants to learn how to play the bagpipe?
You start out on a practice chanter, which is very similar to a recorder, so you don't start on this.
Got it.
And I would say after about 8 months to a year, depending on your ability, mm-hmm. you're ready to order a set of pipes, and then once you get your pipes, it's like starting all over again.
Interesting.
And it takes most people about 6 months to get comfortable with handling, blowing, and then about 2 years before they can eke out a tune.
All right.
So it's quite a process.
Now, Dan, if anybody at home wants to pick up a lesson, young or old, you guys do that, right? We can get in contact with you and help them find out a way to pick up this beautiful instrument.
Certainly. We do teach the pipes and the drums. We start a new class about every 18 months to 2 years, and we'd like to have everybody in the same place.
Nice.
So probably about another 6 months or so, we'll start another group.
Nice. Well, again, we'll have all that information online on where people can get that. Now, I want to talk about St. Patty's Day, though. You guys are probably book solid. What are you going to be doing on today? What's going to be happening? Where can people catch you and your beautiful band, as we'd like to say?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'll start at the Halikoa Hotel. We have a concert there at 10. Then we do the parade, of course, through Waikiki at noon. Mm-hmm. We'll play a couple other places informally, and then back again at the Halikoa at about 3:30, I think. And then to the Outrigger Canoe Club, which would be a private event. And then eventually down to the block party by Murphy's O'Toole's and J.J. Dolan's.
I got to ask, you know, when you're out there in front of the crowd, and it's such an honor to be walking, but your attire, let us say a kilt, which I'm wearing right here, if it's a little bit windy, it must be a challenge. And I got to ask, I mean, you're in position. Talk about your gear real quickly and what you have to kind of help keep things, as we say, down if it gets a little bit gusty outside. But what do we have here?
Well, actually, in the old days, this kilt pin was to do just that.
Keep it together.
To keep it down so that in a breeze it doesn't cause a problem. But this is actually a military-style uniform of the Scottish 42nd Highlanders.
Oh,
this is what's called the Black Watch tartan, and a military-style sporran, as well as the spats and the hose.
Can we hear you guys play a few songs?
Certainly.
Absolutely.
Awesome. But again, thank you so much, Dan.
My pleasure.
You guys are great for being here. Go ahead and take it away.
All right.